The meeting room will come to order. We are now holding a meeting of the District 11 FFA. Madam Vice President, are all officers at their stations?
I shall call the roll of officers to determine that if they are at their stations and report back to you, Madam President. The Sentinel.
Stationed by the door.
Your duties there?
Through this door pass many friends of the FFA. It is my duty to see that the door is open to our friends and that they are welcome. I care for the meeting room and paraphernalia. I strive to keep the room comfortable and assist the president in maintaining order.
The reporter.
The reporter is stationed by the flag.
Why by the flag?
As the flag covers the United States of America, so I strive to inform the people in order that every man, woman, and child may know that the FFA is a national organization reached from the state of Alaska to the Virgin Islands and from the state of Maine to Hawaii.
The treasurer.
Stationed at the emblem of Washington.
Your duties there?
I keep a record of receipts and disbursements, just as Washington kept his farm accounts, carefully and accurately. I encourage thrift among the members and strive to build up our financial standings through savings and investments. George Washington was better able to serve his country because he was financially independent.
The secretary.
Stationed by the ear of corn.
Your duties there?
I keep an accurate record of all meetings and correspond with other secretaries wherever corn is grown and FFA members meet.
The advisor.
Here by the owl.
Why stationed by the owl?
The owl is a time-honored emblem of knowledge and wisdom. Being older than the rest of you, I am asked to advise you from time to time as the need arises. I hope that my advice is always based on true knowledge and ripens with wisdom. Madam Vice President, why do you keep a plow at your station?
The plow is the symbol of labor and tillage of the soil. Without labor, neither knowledge nor wisdom can accomplish much. My duties require me to assist at all times in directing the work of our organization. I preside over meetings in the absence of our president, whose place is beneath the rising sun.
Why is the president so stationed?
The rising sun is the token of a new era in agriculture. If we will follow the leadership of our president, we shall be led out of the darkness of selfishness and into the glorious sunlight of brotherhood and cooperation. Madam President, all officers are at their stations.
Thank you, Madam Vice President. The secretary will call the roll of members.
I am pleased to announce that there are numerous members and guests present, Madam President.
Thank you, Madam Secretary. FFA members, why are we here? To practice brotherhood, honor agricultural opportunities and responsibilities, and to develop those qualities of leadership which an FFA member should possess. May we accomplish our purposes. I now declare this meeting of the District 11 FFA duly open for the transaction of business or attention to any matter which may properly be presented.
Tonight wouldn't be possible without the sponsorship of Ivy Tech. We would like to thank them for sponsoring tonight's district kickoff. Let's take a look at their remarks.
Welcome, FFA members, for your district kickoff. I'm Sue Elsperman, president of Ivy Tech Community College. In the midst of this unusual start of a school year, we welcome students to all 18 of our Ivy Tech campuses, in-person blended, labs, and hands-on courses, virtual and online, and even our new Learn Anywhere model that allows a student to decide every week if they'll come on campus, whether they'll take classes virtually or online. We're learning a whole new level of flexibility during these COVID times. At Ivy Tech, we offer a wide range of workforce and transfer programs. In fact, roughly half of our students will transfer from Ivy Tech to a four-year institution and with minimal debt. We are extremely proud of our agriculture program partnership with Purdue, where every one of our students at our seven agriculture campuses will have the opportunity to a smooth and successful transition through the Pathways to Purdue program. In all, we have more than 500 students at Ivy Tech pursuing agriculture. We're also proud that we can offer you some highly innovative emerging areas like precision agriculture, drones, hydro and aquaponics, and even environmental stewardship. Not sure you want to pursue agriculture? Ivy Tech has a full range of programs from nursing and healthcare to software development and cybersecurity, all to help you launch a challenging, high-impact career. I hope you enjoy your district FFA meetings. Be safe and well, and we welcome you to explore Ivy Tech as your best option for launching your career.
Hi, Indiana FFA. Scott Caldwell here with Ivy Tech Community College. Just wanted to say that we are so proud to be able to sponsor the district kickoffs. We're sorry we're not able to be there in person with you at your school or on one of our campuses, but we do want to say that at some point we would love to have you come and visit us. Come and see what it is that we're doing with agriculture, where we're innovating things. We're embracing the changes that are going on right now. So we are teaching those traditional things that you would normally think of with the production agriculture area, the agribusiness areas, but we're also making sure that we reach the new technologies of things and working at what's changing society today. And that's what we're looking at, trying to help our students get ready for that in an affordable manner. So once again, thank you for the opportunity to be a partner with you to sponsor these district kickoffs. We really wish we could be there talking to you in person, but we really would love to have you come and visit us on our campus. See what it is that we do, how we can be a partner with you to work on your degree or to be able to transfer to work on your bachelor's degree and do that in an affordable, efficient, and effective way. Have a great evening. Talk to you later.
Thank you once again to Ivy Tech for your sponsorship. We cannot hold district kickoffs without your amazing contribution. Indiana FFA is now proud to present our state theme reveal video. Watch to find out what our 2020-2021 state theme is.
For over 90 years, we have faced adversity.
Through challenges,
changes,
and setbacks,
we have proven our strength.
We are not done,
nor will we run.
It's time!
This past June, we were not able to properly recognize our 2020 Hoosier degree recipients, but now we would like to take this time to give them that recognition they so well deserve. Congratulations to this year's 2020 Hoosier degree recipients.
We are so proud of our Hoosier degree candidates. This year, our Hoosier degree candidates have dedicated an average of 68.9 hours to community service, three times the required 25 hours for the degree. The hours they have put in are valued at approximately $758,152. The total earnings for all the candidates in the placement category is the equivalent of $2.099 million. And the entrepreneurial candidates have earnings totaling $1.53 million. By the numbers, the total economic impact of our 2020 Hoosier degree recipients is $4.393 million. Madam Secretary, what have you to report concerning the candidates eligible for the degree?
I am pleased to submit the names of 465 candidates who have been selected by the State Executive Committee and delegates of the 91st Indiana FFA State Convention to receive the State FFA degree.
Our Constitution sets minimum qualifications which must be met before candidates are eligible for election to this degree. Mr. Advisor, have you carefully examined and reviewed the records of these candidates?
I have, Mr. President, and have found all candidates fully qualified.
We will now proceed to raise these members to the state FFA degree. Will the candidates please rise?
The state FFA degree is the highest degree our state association can bestow. Some of you will one day earn the coveted golden key of the American FFA degree. We urge you to maintain throughout your adult lives the same enthusiasm and dedication that you bring to this ceremony today.
It is a great honor to be nominated for the state FFA degree. It is still a greater honor to be selected for this degree by the fellow members of the Indiana FFA Association.
Your new achievement brings you greater honors as well as additional responsibilities. You have widened your field of service and influence in strengthening agriculture, the most basic industry of our nation.
You have been urged to advance towards higher goals in the FFA. We commend you for your accomplishments and encourage you to work toward
new and higher goals in our organization and in your chosen occupation.
In meeting the requirements of the Green Hand and Chapter FFA degrees, you were told that the golden charm of the state FFA degree was awaiting you. The bronze emblem of the Green Hand gave way to the silver emblem of the Chapter FFA degree, which has now evolved into that golden charm. This is symbolic of the growth and development in your chosen occupation. May the permanence of the rare and golden qualities of the emblem be a constant reminder of the strength of your education and the worthiness of your achievement. Therefore, on behalf of the Indiana FFA Association, I confer upon you the state FFA degree with its honors and privileges and present to you this charm, the emblem of the degree. Madam Secretary, please read the names of the candidates.
District 11, Bedford North Lawrence, Garrett Ray Bierbaum, Jacqueline Marie Blake, Angelica Kate Godsey, Brownstown Central, Abigail Nicole Stefflich, Macy Marie Stefflich, Columbus, Hope Flynn, CJ Tillett, Sydney Wheeler, Horton Central, Sammy L. Ripperton, Hoosier Hill, Justin Schnon, Hope, Emily Harker, Nicole Patesel, Marnie Schwartzkopf, North Harrison, Jackson Walter Metz, Orleans, Molly Ann Budig, Salem, Clayton Kelly, Chloe Elizabeth Savins, Scottsburg, Trayton Brown, Jeffrey Blake Dreary, Samuel Lewis Everett, Jameson Bryce Hale, Molly Jordan, Tanner Dane Mace, Heidi Elaine Taylor, Shirley Witt, Seymour, Courtney Michelle Ott, Springs Valley, Bryson Quakenbush, Cody Robke, Kyla Toth, West Washington, Lindy Barksdale, Trenton Benson. Congratulations to our 2020 Hoosier Degree recipients.
As kids, the 2000s hold some of the best memories in our lifetimes. Whether it was waking up early in the morning to watch cartoons or going and playing outside. As we begin this district kickoff, let's take a trip back down memory lane and get on our feet, get excited, and get dancing.
Slightest ease, yes please. I'll be right by now, it'll go to
your head when you write a report on a book you never read. And just snap your fingers, you can make it better. That's what I say. Everything is not what it seems when you can get all you wanted in your wildest dreams. You might run into trouble if you go to extremes, because everything is not what it seems.